Good evening, everyone. Welcome to our virtual BMDCA 2020 Annual Meeting and Awards presentation. Welcome to all our members from around the world, and a special welcome to our newest members and those who would have attended their very first specialty. I'm fortunate to serve as your BMDCA president for a second term, and I'm indeed fortunate to have an experienced and dedicated board to serve with. I would like to recognize our board members for their support of the club and initiatives throughout this past year. Our Vice President, Nancy Stewart, our Treasurer, Pam Weir, Recording Secretary, Carolyn Fox, Corresponding Secretary, Ann Gorso, AKC Representative and Director, Sarah Carl, our Directors, Val Horney, Marae Bichelle, Ruth Nielsen, and Marge Geiger. Their experience and guidance have been very much appreciated, especially during the past few months. It takes 3 years of planning and hard work to put together a specialty. Each specialty is a result of the combined effort of the Specialty Consortium and the BMDCA Specialty Committee. A very special thank you to 2020 Specialty Chair Jill Schaefer, her co-chairs Linda Carney from Finger Lakes, Don Cox from Mason-Dixon, Bob Reed from Potomac Valley, and Sue Van Ocker from Watchung. And of course, thank you to our BMDCA Specialty Committee for all your efforts through these unprecedented times. The hardworking and dedicated specialty volunteers are usually rewarded when they see the smiles on attendees, the camaraderie ringside, the selection of the best in specialty at week's end, and ultimately the post from attendees during their travels home. While the specialty did not take place as planned, the committee pushed forward to provide a virtual specialty experience to fill the week with a sense of community and celebration. I want to thank all our members who participated in the virtual specialty. I would also like to thank everyone who took the time to reach out and recognize and thank the 2020 specialty volunteers for their hard work and understanding after we determined the 2020 specialty would not occur. Please raise a glass to all of our specialty volunteers everywhere. As you know, the BMDCA is an organization that only works because of the dedication and hard work given so generously throughout the year by our talented and supportive volunteers. We are so fortunate to have such volunteers, and we thank you so much for your continued support. Cheers to every single volunteer of the BMDCA. Thank you. The BMDCA board has decided to begin a new tradition at our annual meetings. We will honor those members who have been taken from us since the last specialty. We're only able to honor those that we're made aware of and that are updated in our Bernegard database. At this time, we'd like to have a moment of thoughtful reflection for those members who are no longer with us. Cause you've been my home. Yes, you've been my home. From this day on, now and forevermore. No matter what they say, you'll be here in my heart always.
Good evening. I would like to call this virtual meeting to order. At this time, I would normally establish a quorum, as we had sent out a poll to approve the 2019 BMDCA annual meeting, and a quorum was established by this vote. The motion to approve the 2019 annual meeting minutes from Brainerd, Minnesota has been carried. This year, the BMDCA board will be meeting on Saturday, May 9, 2020. Typically, we meet Sunday before the specialty occurs. We will report on our meeting in our June bulletin. Our recording secretary and our corresponding secretaries have indicated they have no report. As there is no unfinished business from the 2019 meeting and no new business was brought by the membership for the 2020 annual meeting, we will now continue with our program, which includes recognition of our top juniors, the awarding of junior scholarships, our BMDCA Outstanding Service Award, the AKC Sportsmanship Award, and recognition of our 50 and 25 year service awards.
Hello, everyone, and thank you for joining us. This is Debbie Jones, the BMDCA Juniors Advisor. I would like to congratulate this year's top three junior handlers. Statistics are compiled using every win and second through fourth placements, including best junior points. Competition need not be present in the class if the junior wins best junior handler for points to be awarded. 1 point is awarded for every competitor defeated. This year's top junior handler goes to Hunter Calvillage. Hunter defeated 128 junior handlers to garner the top BMDCA Junior Handler Award. Jessica Anakini defeated 75 other junior exhibitors, and Margot Harry defeated 42. I would like to congratulate not just these three young ladies, but all the juniors out there who competed this past year. The love you all show for the breed and sport shows in the dogs you exhibit. Myself and all the BMDCA members out there support you and look forward to seeing all of you in the ring for years to come.
This year, the BMDCA is pleased to present two junior scholarships of $500 each to Jessica Anacini and Charisse Kelly. Well done. Congratulations.
Hi, my name is Deb Bammel, and I'm truly honored and delighted to present this year's Outstanding Service Award to a very dedicated BMDCA member. Our 2020 Outstanding Service Award recipient has served as chair of one of the BMDCA's most pivotal and difficult committees for nearly 20 years, served three terms as a director on the BMDCA's board, is a founding member and officer of her local club, and has served as its RCC rep since inception, has held an important committee chair role on every national specialty held in the Pacific Northwest over the past 20 years. When I set out to nominate this year's recipient, I knew I wanted to reach out to people that worked closely with her. I received beautiful testimonials, too numerous to read tonight. Here are just a few of the glowing words used by peers to describe her. Compassionate, advocate, helpful, an angel on earth, tough to replace, deserving. The recipient of the 2020 BMDCA's Outstanding Service Award is, have you figured it out yet? Want to make a guess? Drum roll, please. Kathy Deo, BMDCA's Rescue Chair. With accomplishments over the past 20 years, too numerous to list, I thought I would share just one of Kathy's selfless, honorable acts as BMDCA's rescue chair. An elderly owner bound for assisted living had to surrender two female littermates that had been together with him from the beginning. The gentleman pleaded with Kathy to keep the girls together, and Kathy assured him she would do her best. The girls lived at Happy Mountain, Kathy's home, until she could find them a permanent home together. Several people expressed interest, but could not take them both. Kathy held firm to her promise to the owner. Finally, after 2 years, a forever home was found, and both girls lived happily together for 4+ years on a Montana farm, both living past the age of 10. Please join me in raising a glass to Kathy for her hard work and dedication on behalf of the BMDCA. Congratulations, Kathy. Here's to the dogs we love and the friends they bring us.
Hi, my name is Susan Henderson, and I have the distinct honor of presenting the AKC Outstanding Sportsmanship Award to BMDCA's recipient for 2020. The Outstanding Sportsmanship Award program was established by AKC in 2006 to honor those individuals that are active in an AKC member club, have made a difference in the sport of purebred dogs, and embodied the code of sportsmanship. This year's recipient has been an active and valued member of the BMDCA since 1998. She has competed and earned titles in nearly every sport our breed enjoys: conformation, obedience and rally, activities such as farm dog, canine good citizen, as well as BMDCA's draft program. She exemplifies the virtues of the AKC Code of Sportsmanship, especially in the following areas: committed to fair play, honesty, courtesy, vigorous competition, as well as winning and losing with grace. Whenever the recipient does not qualify or win the points, she always accepts responsibility, never blaming her dog, other competitors, the course, or the judge. Appreciates the merit of the competition and the efforts of the competitors. The recipient is always very supportive of friends and fellow competitors and always offers kind words outside the ring, even if you didn't get the result you were hoping for. She also always offers congratulations to the winners, even when her dog is defeated. Welcomes, encourages, and supports newcomers to the sport. This is the area where the outstanding sportsman really shines, especially within BMDCA's draft program. She has helped many burner owners gain the skills and confidence they need to participate. She has coached and mentored countless members and newcomers to the Grand Canyon State Club to become successful in draft. She was also instrumental in forming a build your own cart workshop, helping making the sport affordable to everyone. Please join me in acknowledging BMDCA's recipient for the 2020 AKC Outstanding Sportsmanship Award. Nominated by Carolyn Fox, this year's recipient is Jan Nelson. Congratulations, Jan. Thank you for embodying good sportsmanship in all areas of the sport of dogs. Your name will be added to AKC's website, joining all the other distinguished individuals that have earned this prestigious honor.
For more than 50 years, the BMDCA has provided a sense of community and purpose in support of our Bernese Mountain Dogs through our members. We acknowledge and appreciate that the foundation and strength of our club is built upon dedicated and long-standing members such as these here. It is tough to quantify their contributions to our club and our members, as their activism in our community over the many years is evident, as these names are familiar to all. We are thrilled to have another member of the 50-year club. Congratulations to Margaret Smith for your many years of membership. Thank you. Congratulations to our 25 who have reached 25. I know you all have sights on 25 more and that gold pin. On behalf of our membership, I'd like to express our heartfelt gratitude for the many years of service to our committees, our regional clubs, and our activities. Thank you to all our awardees for the many years of service and dedication in making the BMDCA the club it is today and providing a sound foundation for years to come. Thank you. At this time, I would like to thank all the presenters and their helpers who provided content for this meeting. Thank you to Fred Stotch for the award slideshow presentation. Thanks to our records chair, Gary Galunas. Thank you to Renee Jacquier and the awards committee members. These folks make our award programs possible and enjoyable. I will now ask for a motion to adjourn via the chat window. I will now ask for a second to the motion to adjourn the meeting. I now adjourn this meeting. We will now have the passing of the torch from 2020 to 2021.
Good evening and welcome to the first ever virtual awards meeting. Wow, who would have thought when we were planning this years ago that I would be giving you my thank you speech in my office instead of in front of you in the ballroom at the beautiful Host Hotel. It's been a tough couple of months for all of us. And from the 2020 committee, I would like to thank you all for your love and your support that you've given us during this time. It was a very difficult decision to cancel the specialty, but we had to do it for the safety of everyone. So as a result, we've created this virtual specialty instead this week. I hope you all have enjoyed it, whether you've posted pictures or posted comments or participated in the photo contest, the parades, even the funny hat contest that we had earlier. Hopefully you had a good time and it will tide you over until the specialty next year. My 2020 virtual specialty committee was fabulous. Thank you, ladies, all of you. You jumped on it right when I had the idea and just went with it, and I appreciate your help. Going back a little further, I want to thank my 2020 committee and chairs. You have been wonderful. You've worked your butts off, and all we are getting is a thank you. I can't thank you enough for that. And I'm sorry that we can't see our event come to fruition. You've been fantastic, and I appreciate each and every one of you, all the volunteers. My co-chairs, Bob Reeve, Don Cox, Linda Carney, Susan Van Ocker, I could not have done this without you. You were there to support me and keep me standing when I needed your help. So thank you as well. So without further ado, cheers to all of you. I hope you enjoyed this week. And it's time to pass the torch to the next specialty. As you know, this is the lovely torch that we pass, and I'd like to pass it on to 2021 with a few additions this year. Hopefully you won't need these, but just in case, are your gloves and your mask. Thank you again to everyone for supporting us by participating in the specialty, donating, whatever you've done. We love you. Thank you, and good luck to 2021 next year. I look forward to seeing all of you there, and I know we're gonna have a lot of fun. Thanks.
Thank you, Jill, for the care package that came with the torch. The only thing that could have been more welcomed would have been some toilet paper, but I think that would have been a bit too much to ask. But on a more serious note, I want to say that I've been thinking of all of you wonderful people in our burner community during this crazy time. I know that some of us are going through some very tough times right now, and I send my love out to all of you. And I know that all of us want to offer our sincere thanks and gratitude to the 2020 committee for all of the hard work they put in over the last 3 years. We all know you would have given us a wonderful national specialty, but unfortunately, you didn't get to see your dreams fully realized. More kudos, therefore, for putting together the virtual specialty that has allowed us all to come together online. It's been a lot of fun. So hopefully, come May 2021, the worst of these days will be behind us, and you will all be ready to join us May 9th through May 15th in Estes Park for our Burner Base Camp. For those of you who may not be familiar with the term base camp, it is a main encampment providing supplies, shelter, communications for persons engaged in wide-ranging activities such as exploring, reconnaissance, hunting, mountain climbing, and dog showing. We have a wonderful show site at the Estes Park Events Complex. Grooming and confirmation, rally and obedience buildings are right next to each other, and it is just 20 feet out the grooming building door to the confirmation ring. Herding will be on site, and draft will be right next to the events complex. Tracking is 30 miles from Estes Park, and agility will be held in a great facility on AstroTurf. Your first sneak peek of the 2021 National will be posted on the 2020 Paddock Facebook page on Sunday, May 10th. Our website will be coming up June 1st, and you can also join us then at the Trailhead, our Facebook page, as we begin our journey to Burner Base Camp. Trophies will be available to sponsor on June 1st as well. Our Ways and Means store will open in June, and let me tell you, this vest is just one of the many beautiful and unique items that we will have for you at our Happy Camper store. Stay tuned to the Trailhead for our Facebook Live fashion show this summer, along with lots of information about our show site, accommodations, and events. Since we didn't get to see you all in Maryland, we hope that through social media we can convey all the information you need to make your 2021 National Specialty in Estes Park a wonderful experience.